So let's do our examples first and then we talk in detail. Just like yesterday, when I can spend more than 1 hour with you guys. That will be fine. So please keep noting down your question or write in the chat window in a short format so that I can read quickly and I can answer to the question quickly as well. Agreed, guys? Okay. So let's do. So I can see some people are saying, let's move to some other example. So let's move to class A or class B, right? Let me give you something simple. So let's not go with this one. Right. So let's try to solve something like 10.0, which is already there in your literature as well, ./30. So let's convert this one. Either 111 or 11, everything will be same. So let's work on this one because we also have to do the practical scenario as well after this. Okay. So step number one, again, what do we have to do? Step number one, same thing. There is no big difference. So I just want to clarify your doubt. So step number one, we have to write this one in binary. Step number two, we have to write number 30, which is given mask in binary as well, and multiply them by bit by bit. So this is very easy. Let me convert. So 10.0.0.1. So 10 in binary numbers, I already know 0000. And then 10 in binary is 1010. So .00008 times. So I converted it. .00008 times zeros again. .1 is 0000001. And then the subnet mask, what we have to do, /30 means how many times 30? How many times 1? 30 times 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 dot 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, and then remaining two zeros, right? So multiply them together. 1 multiplied by 0 is 0. 0 multiplied by 0 is 0. Of course, it is going to be all zeros, dot. Again, 0, 0. So everything is going to be, let me write in sequence quickly. This one and this one is also going to be 8 zeros because anything multiplied by 0 is 0. And then in here, we are gonna 0 by 1 is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. So this is our first IP. This is 10.0.0.0. So first IP is 10.0.0.0. This is our first IP, or this is our network number. Now again, the same thing, what we have to do, what is the value of H here, guys? What is the value of H? Can somebody tell me? 2. Very good. Now you guys are getting it. So what do we have? Value of H is always 32 minus given mask or minus subnet mask. So we put 30 in here, which gives us H is equal to 32 minus 30, which gives us 2. So it means 2 bits have to be changed to 1 in here. So let me write it here again. 0000001010.0000000. We don't touch anything else other than the last 2 bits. Only these 2 last bits. So 0000000 and then 1 and 1. Why? Because the value of H is equal to 2. So 2 means 2 bits have to be changed. So now convert this one to normal number, which becomes 10.0.0. What is this? 3. Right? So this is our last IP address. Now what is our range? Again, the range is equal to from first IP 10.0.0.0 up to the last IP 10.0.0.3. So how many IP addresses is it giving us, guys? How many IP addresses? 4, yes, and 2 are usable out of that. Also, you can calculate using your formula as well. What was the formula to calculate the number of hosts? total number of IP addresses, 2 raised to, can somebody, does somebody remember what is the formula to calculate if you, we don't follow this whole process? Yes, very good, Mr. Hacker. 32 minus given mask. 2 raised to power H, which is equal to 2 raised to power 32 minus given mask, which is equal to 2 raised to power 32 minus 30 is equal to 2 raised to power 2, which gives us 4. So without doing all of this, if we just want to know how many are there, then we can use this 3 lines only. But if we want to know that what are those IP addresses, then we have to do this whole process. Now you know these 2 steps, the difference. This one tells us what are those IP addresses, first IP, second IP, third IP, fourth IP. But if we want to know only that how many IP addresses are there, very simple, 2 raised to power 32 minus whatever number they have given you. That's all. So let's do some more example in here, because if you understand range, calculating the range is the key to subnetting. Right, so I just got from someone. Now I want to give you an experience, because until now what was happening, all of them were zeros, because I wanted to give you easy examples, right? So let's move to some next example, next level example, right? Again, this is not the question. So question is now, let's do something other than third octet shouldn't be zero now. 192. And it shouldn't be the first subnet. 168.10.44/29. So if I ask you how many IP addresses will it give us, guys? Totally. That is very easy. 2 steps only. 32 minus 29, 3. 2 raised to power 3 is 8. Yes. Now you guys know already, right? Because from 29, you can find it very easily that how many IP addresses will it give us. But we need to know which IP addresses are those. So we need to do the whole calculation of range as well. So let's do it. Very easy. Again, we have to write in binary format, and then we have to write our mask as well in ones format in binary, and then we multiply them. We get first IP, then we calculate the value of H, which is 3, 32 minus 29, and then we change 3 bits. It gives us the last IP. Very easy. So let's do it. So first we have to write 192.168 in that format. Now I am not going to, because once we multiply, 192.168 is always same, right? So you can directly write 192, because you know 192 is gonna give you exactly again 192. But for your easiness, let me write it. So 192, we already know what is that? 1100 and then 4 times zeros. This is 192 in binary. Yesterday we already studied how to convert this to binary. Then 168 in binary is what? 10101 and then 3 zeros. We also know this one. Then 10. 10 in binary is what? So now we have to do some calculations as well. But I already know you can do the calculation. This one in binary is 0000 and then 1010. And then 44 in binary is how much? So 44 in binary is 00. You guys can use your calculator as well. 0010 and then 1100. Please check if it is convert as well or not, if it is correct or not, right? So this one is 10 and this one is 44, right? Idris says, I don't know how to calculate that. Idris, please go through the yesterday's lecture. We studied this in detail. Even today, I have explained as well before starting the session. You can go through the part number 2, part number 3. You will find that how to convert binary to decimal and back from decimal to binary. But you can use calculator as well. For CCNA, you might have to do in exam. For CCNP, for specialists, for CCIE, they allow you the calculator as well. Okay, so we convert it and then we have to write the subnet mask. So 29 in binary, it means slash 29 subnet mask in binary means 29 times 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, all ones. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. All remaining 3 are zeros, right? Then we calculate our first IP address. So we already know, let's do from the left side. So 1 multiplied by 1, 1 multiplied by 1. So this one, of course, is going to give us the same number again. 1100000. Also in here, we are going to get the same 101 because I am just multiplying them, right? And then 10 is also going to be the same 0000 1010. Now the question comes here. So what are we going to get in here? It will be 0 by 1 0 0 by 1 0 1 by 1 1, and then 0 by 1 is 0, and then 1 0 0 0. So we convert this into binary. This is our first IP address. So it will become 192.168.10.40. So here it did not come as 1 or as 0. This last one, in all our previous examples, this was coming up as 0 or something. So this is our first IP address. Then in that first IP address, we calculate the value of H. So what is the value of H here, guys? 3. Very good. H is equal to 32 minus given mask. Given mask is 29. So 32 minus 29 gives us 3. So value of H is equal to 3. It means we have to change 3 bits from this first IP, which will give us the last IP. So we make it 111, these ones, right? Let me write it here. Same thing, 1100000.1010100.401001001. And then these three digits have to become, ones. So because of the value of H is equal to 3, so 3 bits became 1, right? This is our last IP address. So let's convert it. Then it will become also 192.168.10. What is this number in decimal? It becomes 47. So what is our range now? Because this is our last IP. So our range is equal to 192.168.10.40 up to 47. So 192.168.10.47. This is our range. This is our answer. Right? From 40 to 47 means 8 IP addresses. Dot 40 cannot be used, dot 47 cannot be used, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46. 6 IP addresses are usable. Clear on this one, guys? I saw somebody was saying to do class B as well. So let's do one class B as well. Then we move to the next step. It's all same, whether you do class A, B, C, whatever you do, it's all same. Don't worry. Okay, so let's do the last one before we move to the next step. So the next is 172.16.5.34/20. Let's make a little bit big. So /26. Again, same steps. Now it is boring for you guys, I guess. We just write it in binary. Even instead of writing in binary, you know, you can just write, because you know up to 26 bits, nothing is going to change. So the answer is going to be 192.16.5, and then 34 is going to change. Now we already know from our experience, but let's do it for you guys. So 172 in binary, let me try to know that. Let me find some other example where I have 172. So I can copy from there instead of just calculating again. No, it's not there. So let's use calculator, right? So this is how you guys can calculate as well, using the calculator. Also, you can use yesterday's method in which we studied how to do the conversion from decimal to binary. So 172 in decimal is equal to this one in Binary. Okay, very good. I can see some people have converted. Boris said, Okan, Ovovo. Very good. It means you are getting. So let's write it. 1 0 1 0 1 1 0 0. What is 16, guys? Can somebody convert for me? Go to decimal and then type 16, and then we come to know this one straightforward. So because left side we have to put 30000 to make it 8 bits total. So 00010000.5 is how much? So let's convert. Oh, sorry. Let's convert 5 as well. Go to decimal. 5 in binary is 40000 and then 0101, right? And then this 34, can somebody convert as well? Thank you. I can see Trevor, Yoko, very many people are converting. So go to decimal, click on 34, click on binary, you will find this as well. But it's a good idea, the people who couldn't join yesterday or who joined late, they can also see here. So 2 0s 1 0 and then 0010, right? So this is 172. This is 172.16.5.34 in binary. So we just converted them. Now let's write our subnet mask. Very easy, no need of any conversion. 26 means slash 26 means 26 times 1. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 18 19 20 21 22 23 24 25 26, then remaining all 1 2 3 4 5 6 zeros. Clear on this one, guys? You can see there is no difference between class A, B and C. It is just the same method. If your method is correct, you don't have to worry about classes. But there are many methods which, you know, they tell you something else for class A addresses, they tell you another method for class B, then it becomes very complex. So better you follow this method of subnetting, which I told you yesterday and today. Then all your concepts are good for the rest of your life. So you don't have to worry about anything else. So just do the exercises, follow this recording, keep this recording with you. It will stay forever as well. Whenever you have an interview, anything, you guys can just watch this recording. You will understand everything. But I also want to have another session with you guys, in which I will explain you high level that why are we doing all of this. I will not go into mathematics. I will just tell you high level that, okay, how to do the subnetting, why we need. For example, if we have a slash 24, for example, if we have this slash 26, why are we doing this and how is it being done? Just, you know, on the logical level. Or maybe today after the session, I can spend 10 minutes to explain that as well. That will give you the overall understanding, because here we are doing mathematics. But once you are working as a network engineer, you don't have to do mathematics. You can use your calculators as well. So, but your logic should be correct. Okay, so let's multiply them. Very easy. So what will be there? It will be same thing. 1 0 1 0 1 1 0 0 dot. The same thing, 0 multiplied by 1 will be 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 dot. Again, multiplied by 1 is 0 multiplied by 1 is 0 0 0 1 0 1 dot. Here we have to do something. With 34, what is the answer? So we have to find. So 0 multiplied by 1 is 0. 0 by 1 is 0. 1 by 0 is also 0. So 4 zeros. So 4 and 4. You can also write like that. So 4 zeros and then 0, 0, 0, 0. So the answer which came through is, let's convert into binary. So the answer is 172.16.5.0. This is your first IP address, right? So let's calculate our H value and find our last IP address as well. Let's calculate our H value. What is the value of H here, guys? Can somebody tell me? No, not 64. Okay, Conrad, yes. Six, Sheila, Philippus, Jonathan, Oglatse, Shahid Ali. Okay, very good, Boris. H is equal to 32 minus subnet mask, or given subnet mask is equal to 32 minus 26. We have to put here. 26 is equal to 6 bytes from here, from this network number, have to be converted to 1. So very simple, just write this one again, but convert the 6 bytes to 1s. 10101100.0001000. Even no need to write, you know, now you are expert, you can know that this is already 17216.5. Just write the last number. Give me a second. Let me reset the pen. Okay, so here we have to write .0000 4 times. Then this one is 0101.00. Now here we have to write 6 times 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Why? Because the value of H was 6. So we had to convert 6 bits to this one. So let's convert this one now back to our decimal. This one is 172. This one is 16. This one is again same 5. And then this one, I can see many people have converted. Yes, this one in decimal becomes 63. Because from the IP, we can also see 2 raised to power 6 is 64. So I can know it will be 63. But you have to calculate, you don't have to guess until you are expert, right? So this is our last IP address of the range. So what is the range? The range is equal to first IP 172, which is this one, .16.5.0, and last IP address is what? 172.16.5.63. This is our range. So it gives us 64 IP addresses. Also, we can know 2 raised to power 6 is equal to 64. So even we could have known this one from the start without doing the calculation. So clear, guys? This is our range. This is our answer. Now I want you guys to help me something. We did so many examples and you guys were saying that 192.168 is very easy, right? So I want you to work with me now. Let me tell you an IP address and I want you to guess. Just give it a rough guess. If you cannot, it's fine, because I know this is the first time we are doing, but I want to clarify something with you. So if I write the IP address is 192, or let's make it 10, it will be more easy. So let me write 10.0.0.1/30. So what is the range of this one? And will it make any difference if I give you this IP address as well, /30? Will they give us the same range or different range? And if I give you 10.0.0.5/30, okay, all of them are same, you guys are saying, right? How about the third IP address? Is it same or different? Yes, that one is different. This is what I want to clarify with you. So it means that both of them, they belong to the same network, but this one belongs to a different network. The first two, both of them, if you calculate the range, this is why we calculate the range, so that we can know who belongs to where. The range of this one, both of them, is from 10.0.0/30. This is the network and the range is from 10.0.0.0 up to 10.0.0.3. But as soon as you move after that IP address, it means you have moved into a new subnet. So the new subnet is 10.0.0.4/30. So these two are very different networks. It means if you have a laptop, now let's go to practical. If you have a laptop and you have another laptop, if you assign them an IP address 192.168.0.1/30 and you assign 192.168.0.3/30 or 0/2, 0.2/30, it means you can connect them together using a simple switch. So here you can just buy a switch, a layer 2 device, and they will be able to communicate with each other. But if you have a laptop which has an IP address 192.168.0.5/30, now this laptop cannot be connected in here. If you connect, it will not work because switch is a layer 2 device. And now these are two different networks. It cannot work between two different networks. So what we have to do is we have to go buy a router. Right, so we have to buy a router. We have to place the router in between and then connect one point here and the other point here. So this side is one network and this side, all of these IP addresses and router port is one network. So now you can see practically why we need subnetting. And why is it so important? Because if you don't know subnetting, you will be doing all of this configuration wrong. When you will be planning, when you will be working in your job, if you don't know subnetting, you don't know routers and switches as well. Clear on this point, guys? So this is how I want you to sit and think easily. Once you know the subnetting, once you are good with mathematics and everything, then forget about mathematics, forget about calculating, just think logically. That which subnet belongs to where and why do we need the subnet and all of that. Then I can have a session with you guys as well. I can ask you some questions and we can think about scenarios as well. So Toneshi says, how do you solve this subnet, the class C IP, so that you have at least two subnet? Each subnet must have room for 48. What are the two possible subnet masks? You just divide it into two. So /24 can be divided into 2/25. That is the next step we are going to do. So don't worry, Toneshi, let's do the next and last portion of today. Come again on that five. Five belongs to different subnet. So just like we discussed, this is one subnet, this is second subnet. So if you assign the IP address .5, it means they cannot talk to each other. Right, and Christian says, can you come again? Faisal says, please solve an example /16 to /23 with any IP address. Yes, then it will move to the next octet, but let's keep it for our next session, not now, Faisal, because it will confuse. But if you want to do it, I can do it with you. You can send me a WhatsApp message. We can do it as well together, right? Joshua says, what is the 10, 10, 10, 1, 1, 1/30, Joshua? It's okay, instead of calculating, let me show you, because the calculation is gonna land us somewhere same thing. So this is here where you guys need to know the IP subnet calculator. So in this calculator, now you need to start learning, because after CCNA, you guys are going to CCNP. So Joshua Ilya said, now any subnet you guys can write, whichever you told me before. Please write it again. Let's do it together. Instead of doing the whole calculation, let's start using this calculator, and /30 means this one. So Joshua Ilya, this is your, it will give us total 4 hosts, 2 usable IP addresses, and this is your range from 10, 10, 10, 108 up to 10, 10, 10, 111. Right? Gift says, I am still on that point. She says that please check for /32. You can see Gift, it gives us only one IP address. So this is a special case. Let's not get stuck into that of /32. Okay, so Adiza says, Muhammad Shahid Ali, Adiza says 10.0.0.5/30. Very easy. Adiza, we just did it. It will give us 4 IP addresses, right? So Adiza, I am doing this one for you. And we choose /30. So this is your range from 4 to 7. We just did this example. Shahid Ali says 192.168.0.3. Let me zoom it a little bit. Can you see it more clearly now? I think it's better now. Yeah. So this is from Shahid Ali and he says it should be /30. So I chose /30. So Shahid Ali, it will give us 192.168.0.0 up to 3. It gives us 4 total IP addresses and two usable hosts as well. And then Idiza Musa said same thing. Idiza, we just did. Gift said, do this one. Let's us say, what is the first network of 192.168.1.0? So this is from Oglitsa and slash 25. So Oglitsa, this will give us like this. This is the range. 195.1.1.0, 195.1.1.127. Oglitsa, I can see you guys just saw this wildcard mask. So that is something separate, because wildcard mask is something whenever we are writing the commands for OSPF, for access control list, for EIGRP, we use wildcard mask instead of the subnet mask. So this is just the reverse of subnet mask. You minus this number from subnet mask from 255, just minus the subnet mask from 255 each time. So 255 minus 255 0, 255 minus 0, 255 0, this is also 0. And then 255 minus 128 gives you 127, because 1 is not usable. So minus 1 in the last one. But let's not discuss. There was another session in which we discussed this one in detail already. Let's continue what we studied today. Arubmai says, can we use slash 16? Yes, Arubmai, you tell me any IP address. Let's say 172.16.0.5 and slash 16. It will give us these ones. It gives us 65,000 hosts. So the calculation becomes very long. That's why I was saying, let's make the calculation smaller. So let's stay until from 32 until 24 so that we understand the concept properly. And then we move to the second octet as well. Okay, Jeannie says, can we use this one? Yes, Jeannie, of course, any IP address can be used. So Jeannie, you just put this one. I want you guys to do these experiments actually, and then you try to learn. So this, it gives us 8 as well. So if you write these subnets, what I want you guys to do actually, so let me tell you what should we do. So 10 dot 0 dot, start with 10 and small ones, dot 0 dot 1, or maybe start with 0.0. So this is your subnet, right? Slash, start with slash 30. So it means that our range is from 10.0.0 up to 10.0.0.3, right? So start from 24 first, okay? So it means 10.0.0.0 slash 24 gives us how many hosts? 256. It gives us only one network of 256 hosts. Let me write here, so that it will clarify. Guys, this point is very important. So 10.0.0.0/24. This is one big network, and it gives us how many hosts? 256 IP addresses, or 254 usable hosts. If I want you, if your manager or your company wants you to divide this one, so how do you divide? So we want to divide this one into two. So what would be those two, guys? Total are 256. So how many would be in each of them? 128. So we will have 128 hosts here and 128 IPs here. But what would be the subnet mask? The subnet mask would be just the next to this one. So keep the thing same, 10.0.0 and slash 25. 10.0.0.0/25. So it has been divided. You can see network number stayed the same, and 128, sorry, in here. But we divided it into two. Similarly, you can divide this 25 also into two more. So how do we divide? Same thing. The first one will be 10.0.0.0/26, right? The second will be 10.0.0.64/26. So now you divided it further. This is how we can divide and we can use our subnets. But let's do it practically. So let's move to our last topic of today, the sixth topic, in which we divide the networks according to the requirement, right? So somebody gave us this network, this one, and he said that we have to divide this network into four parts, right? So this is the part number 7 of today. the last one. So we have to divide this one into four networks. How many networks are there actually? So there are four networks. Network number one, where they need us to place 62. How many hosts will it give us, guys? How many hosts will it give us? Number of hosts are 2 raised to power 32 minus given mask, right? So is equal to 2 raised to power 32 minus 24. 2 raised to power 8, which gives us 256 IP addresses. So total, it means how many IP addresses we have in here? 256. So out of those 256, yes, there will be recording. Just like yesterday, admins will share the recording of today as well. So out of these 256, they want us to place 62 into this network, and they want us to place 62 in here, then 62 into this third one, and then we need two IP addresses here, because this is also a network between the two routers. Each port on a router is the part of a layer 3 network. Total four networks. It means we have to divide this one into four networks. So practical scenarios on your CCIE level, they go like that. But even if you don't understand this today, it's fine. You leave your things up to the range, that should be enough. But once you understand the range, then it becomes very easy for you to do this one as well, right? So I'll solve one or two examples with you. Somebody says, what is Mr. Don't says, what is VLSM? VLSM is variable length subnet mask. We discussed already that whenever an IP address is without a default subnet mask, it is called VLSM, variable length subnet mask. Other than 24, 16, 8, everything is VLSM for that range, for that class. Okay, so how do we do this one? Here we have to use a concept which is called as donated bit. It is a little bit complex. Let's do one example I'll do with you. You guys try to follow, but first you start from point number one. We had 7 topics today. So today and yesterday. So you start with from topic number one and do everything up to topic number 6, then do it again, watch recording again, then do the everything, then do your home assignment, try to do the examples, everything, whichever are there in these slides. Also, these materials have been shared with you. Then you come to this one. So I would not suggest that in first go, you try to do this one, then it will look a little bit complex to you. Okay. So here, what we have to do, we have to divide this one into four subnets. So how to divide? Let's do. First of all, we need to know what is our given mask. We already know our given mask is /24, right? So how many IP addresses are there? We already know 256. So here the value of H, we have to calculate, because the value of H in this one is different. The value of H, how much is here? We already know. So let's calculate the value of H in the original subnet. This is the core of this one. So original H, and we have to find the new H, means we have to find how many hosts are they requiring now. Once we find this one, then it becomes very easy, because we have to find the donated bit, and then the donated bit is equal to original H. These are some formulas, minus new H. So you find this one here, place it here, then you will find how many bits needs to be changed. Once we know, we can change it easily. So let's calculate. Let me show you how to calculate. How to find the original H, we already know. H is equal to, the formula is 2 raised to power H is equal to 2 raised to power 32 minus given mask. We already know what is given mask here. 2 raised to power 32 minus given mask is 24 in the original one, which gives us 2 raised to power, how much? 2 raised to power 8, and it gives us 256 hosts together. But what is the value of H here? The value of H is 8. Hosts are 256, but value of H is 8. Clear? Now let's calculate the new H. So new, what he wants us to do? He wants us to do 4 subnets. So let me write down here. So this is the original subnet, which is 192, which is 192.168.0.0/24, which gives us 256 hosts, right? They want us to divide these 256 hosts into, let me make it right red color, into 4 subnets. So each of them will have how many? So 256 divided by 4 is equal to 64. So this one will have 64 hosts, this one will have 64 and 64 hosts together. So this is what they want us to do, and they want us to write that what will be the subnet mask, what will be the network number of all these individual ones, right? So we know that the original value of H is 8. So what it will be the value of in this new ones? If total number of hosts are 64, what is the formula for that one? So total number of hosts, again the same formula, 2^H is equal to number of host, which is equal to 256 divided by 4. It means 64 will be there in each of them. So 2^H is equal to 64. What is the value of H, guys? What should we place on 2^ so that it becomes 64? We have to place here 6 so that it becomes 64. It means the value of H is 6 now. Clear up to here? So we have to calculate the original value of H and the new value of H. New means these new subnet, that what will be the required value of H. Of course, if 2^6, then it will give us 64 only. So we came to know from here. Once you become experienced, then you will know by heart. You don't have to do this calculation, right? So we have to divide this into 4. We found the original H, we found the old H, and then we just replace the values of H one by one in the original one. We will find the network numbers, we will find everything for these new ones. Let me delete this one to give us space. They are saying, how did you get 6? Okay, Idris, we got 6 because, for example, if I tell you to h^x is equal to 2. So what is the value of x? You can get the logarithm first of all, or you can just guess it yourself. If I place h^1, it gives me 2, because if I place h^2, it gives me 4, which is wrong. So I have to get 2. So this equation becomes correct. It means the value of x is equal to 1. If I tell you 2^7, or if I tell you 2^x is equal to 4. So what is the value of x here, guys? X will be, of course, x will be is equal to 2, because if we make 2^2 only, then it will become 4. So clear on this point that how we got 6, right? There was a typing in this one. So in this one, so please ignore in the recording. It should be 2^2, not h^2. Okay, also this one should be 2^6. So it means H is equal to 6. We found from here, and the original H what we found from here was 8. Now very easy. We have to find the donated bit, right? So we already saw that donated bit is equal to original H minus new H. So donated bit, let's write it DB like that. So DB is equal to original is how much? 8 minus this one is equal to 6. So value of DB is equal to 2. As soon as we know DB, then the remaining things become very easy. So now we have to calculate the new subnet mask, because of course it cannot be /24. It has to be 25, 26, something more than 24, so that they become small subnet. We have to find that one, which is very easy. So new, so let me give it a different colors. So new subnet mask will be, this is step number 3. So new subnet mask will be is equal to original mask plus donated bits. So original given mask plus donated bit. So original mask was how much? 24 from here, right? And then donated bit is how much? 2. So it means the new mask is going to be slash 26 with all of them, right? Now very easy. So we start writing our new subnet masks, new networks. So the new networks, let me write with a different color. The new networks will be like that. Yes, it is too complex, Dante, but this is the only easiest method. If you try some other methods, they will be even more complex. There are many methods. You can try any other method as well. But then you can come back to this method. We will do another example, Toby, I think, after this one. For the new host, it is the new subnet mask. So original 24 plus donated bits, these two, it becomes slash 26. So as soon as we know that it is slash 26 and two bits needs to be changed. So let's keep on changing two bits and we will know everything now, right? So let's calculate, let's start writing our new subnet masks as well. So what is our original network? Original network was 192. I'm not writing in binary. The first three are going to be same. 192, 168, 0 dot. Original was 0000000. And it was slash 24. Now, how many donated bits we found? There are two donated bits, right? So slash 24 means that this portion is our host portion. So in the host portion from leftmost side, we have to change two bits, these ones. These are our donated bits. We just write all possible combinations in here. We will find everything. We will find our subnet mask. So first, this is the original one. So what are our four network masks? 192.168.0. These two we have to write 00. 00000. So we write all four possible combinations. Let me write first. 00. Second will be 01, third will be 10, and fourth will be 11. Then remaining will stay same. So 192.168.0.00, everything gonna stay same. 192. So these are our four networks which we have divided the original network into. .168.0.0000. So these are our four subnet masks. Of course, these are 192.168.0. Let me write those ones because the space is less now. Let me write in here. So 192.168.0.0/26, because we know from here that it should be slash 26. Then the second one should be 01 is always 1. So 1/26, then 2/26, then 3/26. These are our four networks. So it means, let me delete everything else so that we go back to our original things now. Then you will get the concept that what we have done, if we know the overall picture, then it becomes very easy for us to understand. So what we have done until here, we were given, they had given us one big subnet mask. This one big network of 256 host, which was 192.168.0.0/24. And it was giving us how many host? 256 total IP addresses, this one. They told us to divide into four. So we divided into four networks. Each of those networks are these ones. 192.168.0.1. 0.0/26, which gives us how many number of hosts now, guys? This one gives us how many slash 26? 2 raised to power 32 minus 26, which gives us 2 raised to power 6, which is equal to 64. So this gives us 64 IP addresses. This is our first one. The second one is 192.168.0.1/26 gives us 64 IP addresses. The third one is 192.168.0.0.0 0.2/26 gives us 64, So this is how we can convert .0.26. Now what we do, we just assign these networks any IP addresses we can use. If we have to give to four networks, the network number is this. If you want to know the ranges as well, you know how to calculate the range. So you can calculate the range for this one. You can calculate the range for this one. Calculate, but we can use our calculator as well. So let's go back to our calculator. Let me show you. 192.168.0.0. So the range will be 0 to 63. 192.168.0.0/. You can see /24 gives us 256 host. But as soon as we change it to /26, then it gives us 64 only and the range is 0 to 63. Then the second network was .0.1. As soon as we make it 1, then the second one should be .0.64. Then it gives us these IP addresses from 64 to 127. The third one is 128. It gives us, this is the range from 128 to 129. And then the third one, fourth one is 192. I think there is a typing mistake in there also. So let's go back. Epic Pen. Sorry. We converted it wrong. It is not zero. This one is zero. The second one is going to be 64. Third one is going to be 128. And third one is 192. So this one is not 0123. So this is zero. This is 64. The third one is 128. And the fourth one is 192.3. So these are four networks which we have divided into four. Should we do one more example or it's okay? If it is too advanced for you guys, I think we can stay until range only. And this one, you guys can do after the range or we can have another session. So now what we do, we just take those IP addresses, these IP addresses, and then we start assigning. So how should we assign now, guys? So out of this, this one has given us four networks, right? What are those four networks? 192.168.0.0/26 192.168.0.128/26 and the fourth one is same 192.168.0.192/26. So this has given us four networks. So what do? We assign the first network to here. So it means, even you don't understand the calculation, no problem, just understand the logic from here. So it means the first network we will give to this network 192.168.0.0/26. The second network, let's assign to here. The second network will be 192.168.0.64/26. And third one will be .128/26. And the fourth network will be here because here we also need an two IP addresses. So that one will be from 120. Up to 192.168.192/26. It means now which IP addresses you can give to these hosts. So you can give them, the first computer will have an IP address of 192.168.0.1/26, 0.2/26, 0.3/26, up to 0.63/26. Then once you come to this network, what should be the IP address of the first one? It will be 192.168.0.65, because 64 cannot be used, /26. And last one will be what? 6/26. Default gateway Populer, you can put any default gateway. Whatever IP address you put here on the router, so that should be the default gateway for all of these. But of course, it should be from the same subnet. It should be anything 192.168.0. Anything from 0 to 63 with /26. Why /24 as, oh sorry, it is 26. Not 24. All of them should be equal subnets. Another important point, guys, whenever you are dividing the networks, you have to divide them in equal subnets, in equal subnet mask, in equal quantity. So you cannot divide a network into, if I tell you to divide this network into 5 networks, this is not possible. So this network can only be divided either into one network, which is this one itself. Either it can be divided into 2 networks, 4 networks, 8 networks, 16 networks, 32. You cannot divide any network into anything other than the powers of 2. You cannot divide this network into 3 networks. It's not possible. Cannot divide it into 6 networks. It's not possible. You can only divide into 2 raised to power. But what you can do after dividing this one, let's say you can do this thing to do the optimal subnetting. So you can divide this one into 2 subnets of /25/25, right? But then further you can divide this /25 into /26, 2 more /26. So you can do this thing, but you cannot divide into other than the power of 2. Clear on this point, guys? I think let's not do many examples here, because it is looking complex. Let me show you the calculation which are already there, so that it doesn't look more complex to the guys. So let's go to another example, easy one. Here, what we have to do, then I can take your question so that people who have to leave, they can leave as well. So we have to divide this network into 2 networks. This example is more easy than the previous one. So what we have to do, /24 means it will give us 256 hosts, out of which we have to give 126 in here and then 126 in here. So very easy example. Let's see how do we calculate this one. Yes, there is, Theo, you are right. Very good. There is the first and last IP, which is network number and broadcast number. But I will take all your questions, guys. Let me unmute you one by one, but let's keep everything which is relevant. We'll do a revision and then we'll take your question. Let's go through this example as one, because it is written clearly. Maybe my writing was not so clear. So let's see here, then your logic will be more clear. Can we give 2 subnet behind 1 network? Yes, you can, Khurram, yes, you can. So they told us to divide this network into 2 networks. Of course, what we have to do, step number 1, we have to know what is the given mask of this one. So given mask is 24, it is already written here. No need to worry. Then step number 2, we have to calculate the donated bit, right? That how many bits should be donated. What we have to do for that, we have to calculate the value of original H and the new H, required H value. Original, we already know, this is 24, 2 raised to power H is equal to 32 minus 24, which gives us 2 raised to power 8. It means the value of H is equal to 8 and required number of hosts in the original one, given number of hosts are 256. Now the point is to calculate the new value of H. So how to calculate the new value of H is total are 256, right? So we divide this 256 into 2. You can see here we are dividing by 2, not by 4, because they told us to divide the network into 2, not to 4. Then 2 raised to power H is equal to 128. Value of H is equal to 7, because 2 raised to power 7 becomes 128. So it makes it very clear as well. So this gives us like that, right? So now we know the original value of H and we know the new value of H. So what is donated bit? 8 minus 7, original minus new. So it means one bit should be changed from the host portion, from the leftmost host portion. Now very easy, what do? We write the original network in here, which is this one, 192. I have just converted this 192.168.0.0 into here. So how many donated bits are there? There is only one donated bits. So it means we change only one bit. Put all possible combination. First we put n is equal to 0, then we put n is equal to 1. Then we convert to our normal number. So 192.168.0.0, and the second subnet will be this one. So we have divided. What we have done here, we have divided this big subnet into two smaller subnets. First one is this one, and then the second one is this one. Clear on this example, guys? Let's move to the next one. Any question here? Let me see your question, which you guys have written. I think from here, your concept will be more clear. Okay, Philippus says, if I miss any question, you can paste again. Philippus says, on the first network, are we not supposed to end up to .62 since the last one can't be used? No, Philippus, we have to write all the IP addresses, whether we can use or not. Usable IPs is something different. Total number of IPs is something on which we should focus, because we cannot remove two IPs, then the calculation will be wrong. So we have to calculate everything, but we already know first and last cannot be used. Right. Honesty says, I have a question. Sure, Honesty, please write your question. Richard says, please, we have to practice it via automation so we would know how to apply. Yes, that is better. Better you practice with calculator and then do it yourself on the paper, then you will know everything. Then watch the recording again and again. So you have to watch at least 5 to 10 times this recording and do your practice. Subnetting is not something somebody will teach you and you will understand. Otherwise, you know, until today, you were not joining this session, you would have already understood the subnetting, which you joined many, many sessions previously in your whole life, in your career. I'm talking to the experienced guys, not the new ones. So subnetting is something we have to spend some time. Khuram says, can we give two subnet behind one router? Khuram, your question is not relevant here, but let me answer. So you are saying that we have one router, can we host using one port or not, right? If this is your question, then the answer is no. As soon as you assign the first IP address to this port, if you assign this one, because you have to give an IP address 10.0.0.1/24, it means anything which comes behind this one, either there are 100 switches, 100 networks, all of them should have to be within the same range. So if it's still not clear, please write your further question again. Khuram, I think it's the thing you are asking. Theo answered to Gift. Khuram says, can we give two subnet behind one network? I answered already, okay. Perrin says, at what point do we use these in real life? Perrin, this is the real life which we just discussed. You will face this one when you are working in your real network. They will tell you to divide this network into two. This will be your real network requirement. This is what we are doing here in MTN as well. Toby says, now I get how you get your new host. Okay, very good. Kamiru says, how did we get the new H? New H is 2^H. This one. So we already know that 256 needs to be divided into two networks because this is the question. So 256 divided by 2, which gives us 2^H is equal to 128. So you need to think which value you should put here so that it becomes is equal to 2 128. Of course, this should be is equal to 7, then it becomes 128. So it means the value of H is equal to 7. Clear? And what is purpose of broadcast IP? Khuram says, broadcast is a special purpose IP which addresses to all the hosts in the network. Babur says, where /31 network are used? /32 is a loopback. It means we usually use it on the virtual IP address on a router, which never goes down. We use it for special purposes. /31 is not much usable because it doesn't give you any usable host, but you can use it for experiment purposes and reserved purposes by system. Richard says, is there any software we can use to practice? Richard, this is the software I showed you. This is the IP subnet calculator. Here you guys can do this one. And then use your paper and pen as well. It gives you very good idea. So you click in here, then it gives you the range so that your concept is clear. Once your concept is clear, then calculation is just few steps. You do one or two times, you will learn it very easily. Hazinji says, how do we apply this on packet tracer to create a network? Hazinji, you just put get first IP address. For example, if this is your network 192.168.0.0/29. So you assign the first IP address to a computer 192.168.0.1, 0.2 is the second computer. So you can create a network of the, just drag the computer and start assigning them IP addresses, connect them through a switch. You will know. Conrad says, is the best practice for default gateway is the first or in the first network? No, the best practice, usually people put the default gateway on the router as first IP address, like .1, .0 cannot be, or 254, the second last or the second IP. Kuram says, in real life, we use broadcast IP. Usually we don't use broadcast IP. It is used by system, by the routers and switches for internal calculation and processes. Canon says, difference between subnet mask and host number. Host number is the number of hosts, I think you are referring, right? And then the subnet mask is the value, the second part of IP address, which tells us from where does this IP address belong to. In the formula of DB should be minus, not plus. Aliu says, okay, Aliu, thank you for pointing out. Let me go back. Which one are you saying? Yes, this one is a typing mistake, guys. This one should be minus, original minus new. Thank you, Aliu, for pointing out. And then Kuram says, in live environment, where you say, okay, I answered. Nuruddin, typing error in the formula should be minus. Okay, very good. So I can see there are no more questions. Let me do one more example and then we revise everything. And then I take your questions as well. Then there is a home assignment, guys, after this, which you people have to do. This one. So it was a free training course, free short course for everyone, which has finished today, which is about to finish. So please do this home assignment. It will give you more idea once you do the calculation with your own hands. So take a paper and pen, start doing the calculation. Just open a war with subnetting and then you will understand everything. Then finally, there are some practical scenarios as well, which you guys have to solve. These are almost the same which we have done today as well. So the link was already shared. It will be shared with you guys again as well by admin, but let me paste here as well. So once you submit, I will receive an email by system. I can check your answers. Okay. So this is how this network has been divided, which we just discussed. Now let's go to another example I have done for you. So here they are saying that this is the network 192.168.0.0/29. We have to divide it into two networks, this one and this one. There are two host IPs required in each of them. Can somebody tell me how many IP addresses will this one give us? How many hosts, maximum number of hosts? Very good, very good. Some guys have got it already, yes. So 29, we already know that number of hosts is equal to 2 raised to power 32 minus subnet mask. Given subnet mask is equal to 2 raised to power 32 minus 29, 2 raised to power 3, which gives us 8. So it means this original network is giving us 8 IP addresses and they are asking us to divide it into further 2. So we have to assign 4 IP addresses here and then 4 IP addresses in here. So very simple requirement. You can start with this one, right? So what do we do? All the same steps again. We have to find the donated bit and then substitute the possible values in that donated bit in the original network. That's all. It will give us the original two networks. So we calculate the donated bit. Original value of H, 2 raised to power 32 minus given mask is H is equal to 3 and total hosts are 8 in the original. So it means the new two networks will have how much subnets, how many IPs in each of them? 8 by 2 is 4. It means H value is 2. So original is 3. And this one is 2. So original H minus new H. This is minus, guys, not plus. The typing mistake. So 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. Then the original subnet mask will be how much? It should be added with donated number. So slash 29 plus 1 gives us slash 30. So new subnet mask will be slash 30 and donated bits is 1. So we have to calculate two things. Very easy. Calculate the donated bit and calculate the new subnet mask by adding this donated bit into the original one. So we found it 1, we added into 229, we got 30. So we got these two things. What do we do now? We write the original subnet mask in binary. And then we know that the original was 29. It means there were 3 host bits. Everything else was network bits. So these were network bits and 3 were host bits. So we changed these 3 host bits from the leftmost with the donated bit. So There are two possible values because donated bit value is 1. So first value is 1, this is like 0, and second is 2, 1. So 192.168.0.0 and .0.4. These are the two networks. So we have divided this very big network into these two small networks. Each of them will give us how many IP addresses? 4 and 4. 2 will be usable. Clear? So now there are some exercises for you as well in this PowerPoint, and also there are some exercises in your home assignment you guys have to complete and you have to send. Then this is the IP subnet calculator. It is also, the link is given in here. Also there is a quiz. The link is given in here. There are some cheat sheets as well, which I showed you yesterday. So once you are good with the subnetting, then you can use these cheat sheets. These sheets are actually the summary of your whole original topic. Here it tells you everything, and this one tells you, if you can print this one, this tells you to have an idea in your mind. This is how I know as well, that /32 gives you only one IP address, and this is the subnet mask. /31 gives you this one, but better you start from 24 and go up to 30. So this one you should learn by heart. It gives you a very good idea. So these are the cheat sheets. They come with every topic. So if you go for the other training courses as well, you will see that there are these cheat sheets. For example, this is about OSI model, and it is very good for the printing. But I would suggest that you guys print these ones and paste on your wall, wherever you are sitting, wherever you are studying as well. So then automatically these concepts will be in your mind after some time. It tells you everything about OSI model, protocol at each OSI model, everything. So these are the cheat sheets, which gives you a very good idea on each and every OSI model topic. So this is about network topologies. This is about TCP/IP. This one is about IPv4 subnetting, VLAN and trunks as well. These are about wireless, Wi-Fi. It tells us everything about them. Then these are about OSPF, but these sheets are containing the detail of all topics. And then there are some animations as well, which we have prepared for you. For example, we prepared for you this one about VLANs and trunks, how do they work, right? So we prepare these kind of videos as well for you. So they come with the full training course. Anybody who is interested to go for the full training course, you can also understand. You can also register with admin, and we will study all the topics like we studied this subnetting yesterday and today. So this training course was free for everyone. Yes, of course, you guys already have the people who are Toby Alexander. I think you are already the part of the full training course. So anybody who else wants to start, who wants to join the full training course of CCNA or specialist course as well, please write your full number with country code like +91+234 so that you guys can join as well. So let me revise this lecture. Yes, Sterling, the cheat sheets are also there. I think that you are already there in the full training course. If you are still missing, you can send a message to admin as well. So let's revise quickly. So we have studied yesterday and today about IP subnetting. Then I will unmute you one by one to ask your questions so that it clarifies your concept, and the people who have to leave, they can leave as well. So let's summarize quickly. Galaxy S8 Plus, please write your full number with country code so that admin will share the detail of the full training course with you, because I saw you are saying you're interested. So IP subnetting, we discussed yesterday and today, total 7 topics. The first one is about fundamentals. Second was about IP address classes, then conversion from decimal to binary, and then back from binary to decimal in point number 4. Then we calculated the maximum number of hosts in a network and the range of IP addresses, and then some real world scenarios, which we did today as well. So let's summarize quickly each of them. So fundamentals of IP subnetting, we have two parts of IP address. The first one is IP and the second one, the IP itself, and the second one is subnet mask. IP address tells us that what is the number of the host, while the subnet mask tells us that from where does it belong. For example, if we see this whole network, then we can easily identify that from where does this IP address belong to. Of course, this one belongs to network number 2 in here. Why? Because the range is this one. So we need subnetting so that we can decide, we can define the boundary of our networks, right? Using the subnet mask and the network numbers as well. Then the current standard of IP is RFC 791. I would suggest that you guys study this one in detail. And the IP is a 32-bit number. It has two parts, which is network portion and host portion. It is represented by dotted decimal notation. And the IP address, if it is found with the original default subnet mask, it is called classful. If it is found with any other subnet mask, it is called as classless. First and last IP address cannot be used. We have studied this in detail. Now you understand this point. I think you understand all of these points now, right? If the subnet mask can be written, IP and subnet mask can be written in binary, and it can be written in normal numbers as well. So we saw the example of classroom. So for example, we have a CCNA batch which is running currently. So we write the roll numbers of the classes in this format. This tells us that the first few digits, first few numbers are fixed, and then some numbers are changing. The same thing is with IP address. Some numbers will keep on changing, which is called as host portion. Some numbers will be fixed. Now, after doing all the practice, if you see this example, you will understand everything, that the host portion 192.168.0 was fixed, while the last number will keep on changing. For example, if we have 10.0.0.0/20 or /30, if we have this subnet, so which IP addresses will be this one, right? So this one will give us the first IP 10.0.0.1. The second will be 10.0.2, 0.3, 0.4. So you can see that when we start from first to last IP, there are some numbers which are changing, and there is a portion which is fixed, right? Now you compare this one with your decimal numbers, then you will understand. Is it better now, guys? So this is called your host portion. This is called your network portion, right? This is how it works. You guys can easily study. So also we can divide the networks. The purpose of subnetting is to divide one big network into two small networks so that we can use them, or combine the two networks into one if our requirement is like that. So you should know that how to divide these ones. For example, if we have so many students in one class, of course we cannot house them in one class. So we have to divide them into two classes for easy management. 100 students will be 50 in one class and 50 will be in the second class. So similarly, if our requirement wants us to divide a network into 2, 4, 16, then we can divide them as well. So we have this /24. You already saw that how we divided with the help of the donated bit. So we divide it into two networks with /25 and /25, 0 and 128. Now we already know that how to do the ranges also. I can see some people are writing their number. Guys, only write your number if you are interested in full training course, or if you want anything, please also write, I want free study materials, or I want this and that. If you just write the number, it is not useful. Please write if you want full training course of CCNA or CCNP or specialist, so that admin can share the information with you. Please write your full number, not the half. Okay, so why we need subnetting at all? We need subnetting for easy network administration, for better network performance, for improved network security. For example, if we have this large network, which gives us 256 hosts, we already studied and we know now how to calculate this one. So we will assign out of these 256, 30 here, 27 here, 30 here, but of course we will assign them either 32 or either 64. we cannot assign 27. So in that case, 5 will be wasted, which is normal, right? So after that, this is how we got 5 subnets and we assigned everything as well. We assigned all of them. Then we have IP address classes. So totally there are 3 classes, class A, B, and C. And this is the default mask. How do we identify from the first octet we can find? If it is between 1 to 126, it is class A. If it is between 128 to 191, it is B. There is class D and class E as well, but we don't care about them because they are not involved in subnetting. And then this is the default subnet mask. It means if there is an IP address which is 10.0.0.1, it should always come with slash 8, then it will be called as class full. But if this is found as with any other IP address, with any other subnet mask, sorry, if it is found with slash 9, slash 10, then it is called as class less. So this is the difference between class full and class less, right? Then these are some exercises which you guys have to do. Now then we also learned how to divide, how to convert decimal to binary. And section number 4, we also learned how to convert back from binary to decimal. So it was very easy, I hope, for you guys. Then we just write our old school method. We write in this format, we keep on dividing and we keep on writing the remainder on our right side as well. So then we keep on dividing. We went through some examples as well. I want you guys to finish these exercises as well. So then we learned binary to decimal conversion as well. Right, so we write these numbers, powers of 2, and then we multiply and divide them to find our decimal number. Then we discussed in section number 5 how to calculate the maximum number of hosts. Very simple, now everybody knows about that. 2 raised to power h, which is equal to 32 minus given mask. So we just subtract this number. We just subtract this number from 32 and make it 2 raised to power so that it gives us the idea. It gives us the number. And then out of those, we have to minus 2 always, because first and last one cannot be used to get our usable IP addresses. Then in the last one, in the sixth one, we calculated the range of IP addresses. What we have to do, we simply have to write this number in binary and then write this number in the forms of 1. We multiply bit by bit and it gives us a first IP. Then in the first IP, we calculate the value of H and those H bits have to be converted to 1, which gives us the last IP address. So from first to last, we already know what is our range. Once you do the practice, then it will be easy for you guys to go through it. Then in next section, we went through some scenarios as well, that how to divide. If a special requirement comes to divide a network, how do you plan that? For example, if somebody tells us to divide this one into 2 networks because they don't want all 256 hosts to be wasted on one side and then they buy another host again. So they told us to divide into 2 networks, 126 each. So we said, yes, it can be done very easily. We found our donated bit with the help of new and current value of H. So original value and new value of H, we minus them. This is minus and then we get the donated bit. This donated bit we add to the original subnet mask. We get the new subnet mask. Then in our host portion, we know that the original was slash 24. So it means 24 bits were the network portion. So in the host portion, we start from the leftmost side and start substituting the values of donated bit, all possible combination. If the donated bit is 1, of course, it gives us 0 and 1 only. If donated bit is 2, it gives us 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. If donated bits are 3, it will be total 8 combinations. The first one will be 0, 0, 0. Second will be 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. You already know it. We did it in our school last time. 1, 0, and 1, 1, 1. So it will give us 8 subnets. This is how we can divide the network. So if we are given this big network, like this, we divide it into these 2 small networks and the host IPs have also been divided into 2. Then there is an online calculator which you guys have to use. I showed you also how to use this one. You can save this link with you for always. Whenever you have to do practice, whenever you want to do the calculation for your network, then you can use this one. And then there are some quizzes. There are some free cheat sheets, some materials which have been shared. And then there are full training courses which are also going every month. So anybody who is interested for CCNA, for CCNP or specialist courses, you guys can write your full number here as well, so that admins can contact you. They can share the information of those with you as well. So you go to our website simply. In our website, go to the training course, whichever you are interested for. For example, you are going interested in CCNA. Go there, all the details are there as well. Then you can click on the payment button. You can make the payment or you can talk to the admin as well. Here you will enter your email address. You can also make payment by PayPal. There is a full training course for specialist as well, which is going on. So both CCNA and specialist training is starting this month, next week. So anybody who is interested, you guys can enroll. We will study everything in detail. You will get all the materials, all cheat sheets, whatever we studied yesterday and today. So we will study in this way extensively once you go for the full training course. So the next batch, batch 26, is starting next week for specialist. Also, it is starting for CCNA as well. So this is the schedule for the specialist training course. This tells us day by day what we will be studying in detail. So it tells us class one will be on which date. You can get this one from admin. There are some extra classes as well, which you guys can go through. This tells us the date and time. So it is starting from 2nd of August, but some extra classes are starting from next week. Similarly, CCNA is also starting next week. So now I can unmute you guys one by one. You guys can ask your questions, anything about our lectures of yesterday and today. So thank you everyone, guys. Anybody who is interested to continue with us for the full training course, please write your full number so that admin can contact you. Calculator link. Okay, Philippus, let me share with you as well. Please save it with you. This is very useful. This is the calculator link, guys. And then for the CCNA training course, let me share the link of that one as well with you. This is for the CCNA full training course. No, there is an assignment, Nakesh, today. There is no quiz today. This is CCNA full training course link, guys. And then this is for specialist as well. I hope this was informative for you guys as well. So please stay in touch. Bill Brook, it was shared already, but okay. Bill Brook is saying he wants to get the slides of today. So let me share those slides with you guys again. But it was shared in your group as well. So let me drag it here. Okay, you can download it from there. And all the students for batch 25, I think they have some questions as well about the schedule. Guys, the schedule, last week you said you want to go for subnetting in detail. So we thought, let's invite the people who also want subnetting, who want this free as well. So we invited them, but next week will be your training course only. So we will study, we will continue with IP routing with your schedule as well. So don't worry about that. The schedule is still on track. And next Saturday and Sunday, we will see you with these topics, which had to be on this weekend. So is it clear, guys? So now next weekend on 25th, 26th of July, what we are going to study, we are going to study these ones. So we have not skipped these. I'm talking about the batch 25 people who are already with us. Clear on this one, guys? Anyone from batch 25 who wants me to clarify something? Thank you, Tomike. Thank you, Andalovo. Okay, thank you, Christian. Yeah, I think Christian is from batch 25. So any question, guys? Let me unmute you one by one so that I can. Okay, thank you, Conrad Toshini as well. So next week, we have not skipped anything. We just put some emphasis on subnetting, and I hope it was useful for you guys as well. Thank you, Azinji, Lord Obey. Yeah, now I can see batch 25 people as well with me. So, but it will be only you guys next week. Okay, anyone, any question, guys? So now I want you to watch the recording again and again so that it is easy for you guys. Kolibe has a question. Okay, Kolibe, let me unmute you as well. But it will take some time. Thank you, Mohammed. Welcome. So thank you, guys. The session has finished. Now let's continue question and answer so that it will clarify your concept as well.